I made one of these fancy things which has got a cross captivated inside of a cube, but it's really not that exciting, so I thought I'd still try to make a cube within a cube, within a cube type thingy. But I don't want to do it in a way that's been done before, so here is the square and the cubes that I want to cut, but I'm going to cut these with a dovetail bit, and I'm going to cut a squarish hole, and I've already made my pantorouter template to guide the bit. But it gets trickier than that because this bit actually doesn't plunge. So I've pre-drilled some holes in here already so I don't have to plunge with the bit. But another complication is I can't go and cut the inside one first because I won't have enough clearance out here. So I'm going to have to pre-cut some of this with a bigger bit. But I can't cut all the way with a bigger bit first because I don't want to loosen the internal cube. So this is going to take a whole bunch of steps. So now I have my outside cavities carved so I have clearance for the shank of the dovetail bit when I go in there to cut out the inside cube. So starting to form an inside cube, you can see I'm breaking through here just a bit with the corner still attached. I have to be really careful with this because when I plunge in and out, I have to be right in the middle so I don't gouge the edge of the dovetail. I think I should really cut this inside cube loose before I cut the outside cube because right now I still have support, so let's see if I can get that with a knife. Got that inside cube all freed up, but I chamfered the edges on it because it was really hard to move that thing in there. It's very tight. So at least there's no risk of it coming out while I route the next cube out. So to move the follower into the other template, I had to move the template, which means I had to realign everything here. And I used some score lines again to check with the motion of the router bit to make sure I had this on center again. So I've got five faces of this cube cut for these faces, except for here now. But I don't think I have to worry too much because there's still a fair bit of wood joining that inside most one, so it won't jump loose when I cut that last face. I did have to cheat a little bit. Some of these gaps weren't big enough, so I reoriented the cube on the jig and cut some of the faces again. And so something's a little bit off-center, but so far right now it's looking pretty good. Now I just have to separate that inside cube without destroying the whole thing. I think a little chisel like that actually works better than a knife. I kept slipping with the knife and gouging the rest of it. Got it free. I definitely need to chamfer that a little bit because it's hard to move it. Got the edges all chamfered on the inside, so this moves fairly freely now. I have to say, it did turn out much cooler than this cross within a cube puzzle.